I'm Sinead, and welcome. Today we're going to walk down this lovely path of green and see what is happening at the pottery shed. We got flowers. Ooh, look at the ferns. Gorgeous. I'm actually allergic to ferns, but I still think they're pretty. And I believe those are salmon berries coming up. We also have a tree here that has created itself into a lovely little bower. It fell over in one of the storms, but it's still alive. So we're gonna get on down here. I'm actually gonna set up the camera here in a second. Hello, Joey.
Hello.
So what are you making today?
I'm making mushrooms.
All right, well, let me get the camera set up and we'll watch you do that.
All right, so we're making some mushroom decorations for mugs. I'm throwing them off the hump. And it's actually really good practice for my lid knobs. You just get to have fun making different shapes. We have lots of mushroom examples out here in the woods so that they can inspire me. I really love the pixie cup mushrooms because pixies are cups. So we also like to make them for our cups, mugs. The ones people get to drink out of, not the ones pixies get to drink out of, but we pretend. And they are all dipped in like that, and so when you put glaze in them, it pools really pretty. I have to make about 26 of these. And I like to make sure each mug has a variety of mushrooms. We don't really want our mugs to match. I like to make sure everybody can tell their coffee cups apart. Once these reach leather hard, I will probably facet the surface with a knife. Because that also creates pretty breaks in the glazes used, making thick and thin spots in the color. Makes it look sparkly. Getting a sun break here.
It's reflecting on my glasses, so yeah.
Lovely. We love sunshine. Especially on rainy days.
I was going to ask you what kind of mushrooms, you know, how do you decide what kind each one each time? And my guess is it's organic.
The clay tells me all I need to know. But sometimes I also just look at my, what I've already made and go, oh, I haven't made any of the pointy-topped mushrooms. Everybody likes a pointy-topped mushroom. Can't leave those out. I try to make sure my stems are long enough to work with. all the tiny considerations.
Do the stems sometimes get cut in the process of putting them on?
Yes, we often trim them to suit the arrangement on the mug. So you actually want a longer stem rather than a shorter stem because it gives you more options. To make sure my hump stays centered.
So it can get off center in the process?
It can, especially as you pull up a narrow piece of clay. It can get quite wobbly and then difficult to work with.
Sounds like it's starting to rain. I love it. Sunshine and rain.
Ooh, there's going to be a rainbow someplace.
So I think we'll stop since I am actually standing in the rain. And we'll say bye. Bye-bye, Joey.
Bye.